वेलकम बैक फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी टॉक अबाउट द न्यूमेरिकल्स ऑफ द लास्ट चैप्टर. सी, बिफोर आई एक्सप्लेन यू द न्यूमेरिकल्स, फर्स्ट यू अंडरस्टैंड सर्टेन टर्म्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज मेंट बाय क्रिटिकल वेलोसिटी? सी, क्रिटिकल वेलोसिटी इज अ वेलोसिटी विद व्हिच अ सैटेलाइट इज प्रोजेक्टेड सो दैट इट विल मूव इन अ सर्कुलर ऑर्बिट अराउंड द अर्थ. द जनरल सिंबॉल विल बी VC. सेकेंड इज एस्केप वेलोसिटी. Escape velocity can be defined as the velocity with which an object is projected from the Earth's surface so that it escapes Earth's gravitational influence and goes in outer space. Okay, so that is called as escape velocity. Formula for escape velocity is V equal to under root 2gm upon r. And formula for critical velocity is square root of gm upon r. Here r stands for radius of orbit, that I will show it on the board. Now third thing is to know the time period of a satellite. The time taken by a satellite to complete one revolution is called as time period. Now time period of any revolution depends on two factors. One is the radius of the orbit or circumference of the orbit. Second is velocity. If the velocity is more, velocity is high, then time period is less. If velocity is less, then time period is large. So it is inversely proportional to velocity. Secondly, it will depend on radius or circumference. If the circumference is small, it will take less time. If the circumference is large, it will take more time. So these three formulas you have to understand. First, critical velocity. Second is escape velocity. And third is time period of revolution of satellite. So understand these three things on the board first, and then we'll solve each and every numerical from the text. Now the three formulas you have to understand. First of all, understand this. This is the Earth. Capital M stands for mass of Earth. Capital R stands for radius of the Earth. H is the height of the satellite above Earth's surface. Small m is the mass of the satellite. Okay, small m stands for mass of satellite. Small r stands for radius of orbit. And VC stands for critical velocity. So the first formula we look here is critical velocity, given by under root gm upon r plus h. Okay, VC equal to under root gm upon r plus h. Time period of satellite is t equal to 2 power upon VC, or 2 power upon under root gm upon r. When you bring r on in the numerator and bring this term inside the square root sign, it becomes 2 pi under root r cube upon gm. Gm are constants, so the equation can be written as t square directly proportional to r cube. So this formula you remember, this formula, okay, these are will be useful in the numericals. So first, second formula and the third formula is for escape velocity, given by under root 2 gm upon r. R is radius of earth, m is mass of earth, g is gravitational constant, okay, universal gravitational constant, and 2 is also constant, so square root of 2 gm upon r is the formula for escape velocity. And on earth, you should remember, escape velocity on earth is 11.2 km per second. This you have to learn, okay? Keep in mind, escape velocity on earth is 11.2 km per second. See, we'll solve the first numerical. Okay, what is the first numerical? I'll read. If mass of planet is 8 times the mass of earth, and its radius is twice the radius of Earth, what will be the escape velocity for that planet? Okay. So, first of all, in the solution, I will write, let ME be mass of Earth. Be mass of Earth. And RE be radius of Earth. Okay. ME be the mass of Earth and RE be the radius of the Earth. Getting it? Now, by formula, okay, escape velocity on Earth is given by square root of 2GME upon RE. This is equation 1. Okay, under root 2 gme upon re.
This is a general formula which I have just now written. This is equation 1. Now let MP be mass of planet, okay, and RP be radius. Okay, one more thing. This value I know, huh? Escape velocity on Earth is what? 11.2 kilometer per second. This is equation 1. This value I already know. On Earth, I have to find one on the planet. Okay, so let MP be the mass of planet and RP be the radius of planet, and therefore escape velocity on planet will be V escape of planet equal to square root of 2 GMP upon RP. Call it as equation 2. Okay. Now they have mentioned the relation between masses of Earth and masses of planet. What they given? But they have mentioned that mass of planet is 8 times mass of Earth. But MP is 8 times ME. And radius of planet is how much? Radius of planet is twice that of Earth. Twice that of Earth. Okay. These values I call as a equation 3. Okay. Now I got equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3. Now first I will divide equation 2 by 1. Dividing equation 2 by 1. What will I get? See. V escape upon V escape for planet upon V escape for Earth will be equal to 2 GMP upon RP divided by 2 GME upon RE. Correct? Now, inside the square root sign, 2G will get cancelled. What remains is MP upon RP into RE will go in the numerator. This. Now substitute values from equation 3. Equation 3 I have already written. MP is what? 8ME. MP will be written as what? 8ME into RE, and RP is written as twice RE into ME. Now look carefully. What you are getting here? Something is getting cancelled. Right? Something is getting cancelled. What is that? ME and RE will get cancelled. 8 upon 2 is what? 4. Square root of 4 is what? 2. Right? Square root of 4 is 2. 8 upon 2 is 4. Square root of 4 is 2. So I get this value as 2. Now final part. Okay? See here. This part I obtained. The value of ratio is 2. Now V escape for planet upon V escape for Earth. This value I already know. It is 11.2 kilometer per second equal to 2. So escape velocity of planet will be 11.2 into 2. That is 22.4 kilometers per second. Therefore, escape velocity on planet will be equal to 22.4 kilometer per second. Okay, this is the final answer. 22.4 kilometer per second. Getting it? Okay, let's now talk about the numerical B. I have written numerical first. What is given here is that how much time a satellite in an orbit of height 35,780 km above Earth's surface would take if mass of Earth would have been four times the original mass. Okay, so they are asking you if the mass of Earth was 4 times the original mass, what would be the change in the time period of the satellite. Okay, so let us understand this, that they are not changing any height of the satellite. Height is same, but they are asking if the mass of Earth would have been 4 times its original mass, then what would have been the time period of satellite. Okay, now first of all, let M1 be mass of Earth and T1 be time period of satellite. Okay, now they have not mentioned here it is how much is the time period, but you have to understand, since height is 35,780 km, okay, the time period T1 will be equal to 24 hours. Okay, this you understand. Now by formula T1 is 2 pi r upon Vc. Okay, but what is Vc? 2 pi under root gm upon r, and I told you that we can write this as 2 pi r cube upon gm, square root of r cube upon gm. This I already told you. Now here 2 pi g and r, all these are what? Constants. Okay, therefore I can write T1 inversely proportional to root M1. Okay, I get this relation, T1 is inversely proportional to square root of M1, because r cube, g and 2 pi, all these are constants. So T1 inversely proportional to square root of M1. Also, now let M2 be mass of Earth, okay, where M2 is 4 times M1, they have mentioned this, and T2 be time period. T2 be the time period, which we have to find. If the mass of the Earth becomes 4 times, what is the time period? And again, I will write the same formula, T2 inverse proportional to 1 upon square root of M2. This is equation 2. This was equation 1 and this is equation 2. By mistake, I wrote here 2. Getting it? So I got two equations, one is for T1, one is for T2. Now divide equation 2 by 1. Divide equation 2 by 1. What do you get? T2 upon T1 equal to square root of, it will be reverse, M1 upon M2. Now what is M2? Just now wrote 4 times M1. M1 upon 4 times M1. What do you get here? M1, M1 gets cancelled, remaining 4. 1 upon square root of 4 is 2. So it becomes 1 by 2. Or T2 will be T1 by 2. 2 and that is T1 is how much? 24 upon 2, that is 12 hours. Therefore, time period of satellite, if mass of Earth, if mass of Earth is how much? If mass of Earth is 4 times, if mass of Earth is 4 times is equal to 12 hours. This is our final answer. Hope you understood it. Okay, hope you understood this. It's a simple question. Okay, we'll now talk about the numerical C. What they have asked, let's see. If the height of a satellite completing one revolution around the Earth is in T seconds, capital T seconds, is H1 meter, okay? Height is H1 meter. Then what would be the height of satellite taking 2 root 2 capital T seconds for one revolution? Means for capital T1, for capital T, they have mentioned the height is what? R plus H1, and for 2 root 2 into T seconds, okay, they are asking you to find a height, okay. See how I am solving, it's in a very simple manner, please pay attention. I will write, let T seconds, okay, be the time period of satellite, okay, T seconds be the time period of satellites when it is at height, okay, R1 equal to R plus H1, okay, height of the orbit, radius of orbit is R1, or it can be written as R plus H1. Therefore, by formula, it can be written as, if you remember this formula, T square directly proportional to R1 cube. T square directly proportional to R1 cube. Call it as equation 1. Okay? Now, let 2 root 2 t seconds be time period of satellite when it is at a height, when it is at, actually here instead of height na, when it is in orbit, when it is in orbit, R2 equal to R plus H2, okay, orbit radius is R2, so R2 is capital R plus H2, this I have explained to you earlier. So what will I write here? 2 root 2 t the whole square directly proportional to R2 cube. Call this as equation 2. Correct? No issue. Now divide equation 1 by 2. Let us now divide equation 1 by 2. What do you get here? See, T square upon 2 root 2 into T the whole square, into
2 root 2 into t the whole square equal to r1 cube upon r2 cube. I'll write as r1 by r2 the whole cube. Okay. Now this, what you get? T square upon 2 root 2 ka square kya hoga? 8. R1 by r2 I write as r plus h1 upon r plus h2 the whole cube. Correct? T square will get cancelled. We get 1 by 8 equal to r plus h1 upon r plus h2 the whole cube. If I will take cube root, I can remove this cube. Taking cube root on both sides. On both sides. What do you get? Taking cube root on both sides. Cube root of 1 by 8 equal to taking cube root of this is r plus h1. R plus h2. Cube root of 1 by 8 is 1 by 2. Right? Cube root of 1 by 8 is 1 by 2. So that can be written easily like 1 by 2 r plus h1 upon r plus h2. Cross multiply, what you get? R plus 2 H1. Therefore, height of satellite, okay, height of satellite for 2 root 2, 2 root 2 T seconds time period will be r plus 2h1. This is our final answer. Okay. Hope it's very clear.